nose is itchy. What's going on, guys? Welcome back to Just JP. Hope that your day is moving well, moving along just dandy. Today we're going to listen to David Sancious and Tone. We're going to listen to Sky Church Hymn Number 9. This is off of the album Transnarration. That's not what I'm trying to do. The Speed of Love, which was released in 1976. So we were gifted. I always say we, even though I guess technically it's me, but in a sense, I mean, everyone's included. I was gifted the actual album here. Let me take it out of the little slip right here. By one of our lovely subscribers here in the community here. So I figured, you know what? Let's go ahead and give it a listen, give it a whirl. I don't really have anything to hold it up. I can put it against the wall, which I think will kind of work. It'll hold for now. Let's just use Beefy to hold it up just in case there. So we listened to the first track off the album. Let's just move along with where we are. Listen, you guys are extremely generous in all the music you send over. I'll never be able to listen to everything. I hope everyone knows that. I'll never be able to listen to everything, but I am actively trying to incorporate a little bit here and there. There's a lot. There's a lot of music to cover, but I hope that you guys are enjoying the channel. Hope that you're enjoying the choices, and let's go ahead and get into it. This is David Sancious and Tone with Sky Church Hymn Number 9. What happened? Thank you. In the morning. If you were sleepy this morning, that must have woken you up just a little bit. Okay. that moved through so many different stages. It moved from almost like a country blues style, then it just got pure fusion, then moving back into that. Like that, this is a song of changes. This is a song of transformation. this piece, I should say, had a lot of transformation, some good tone, and a lot of speed. And I would imagine it was made with a lot of love. All of these guys should be arrested. Mr. Sancious on the guitars in this track should be arrested for arson, because he absolutely burned the studio down, I can tell you, when he played this. Yeah, just ashes. Gerald Carboy on the bass should be arrested for speeding, because he was burning rubber on this. Ernest Boom Carter. Yeah, I see why his nickname is Boom, because some of the sections with his kick were just stomping. What? He's going to be arrested for abuse, because he abused that set. That drum set is dented, and no, none of those like car dent things, like you pop out the dent, that's not going to fix it. No, those heads are throbbing. They got migraines. He gave the set migraines. This was an extremely well put together piece. All of them just really coming alive. Like I said, hitting it with speed and love. I don't know a lot about David Sancious. Matter of fact, I don't know anything really about him. But there is a southern charm to the music itself. So it makes me curious where David Sancious is from. Does he have roots in the south or anything like that? And just looking at it, he was born in New Jersey. I don't see anything else in here, at least immediately, about that. But there is definitely, in my opinion, a Southern American, not South American, but Southern American blues country kind of sound to this, you know? And the way that he burns it up when they all burn it up when they get into that fast and furious fusion section, really, it is just mind-melting. It reminds me of the chaos that was unleashed on me when I listened to Noonwood Race by Mahavishnu Orchestra. And that, you don't need coffee for that. That is musical caffeine. You feel burned after that. And yet, throughout all of that, they keep it together. It's hot, it's heavy, but they're jamming out, they're grooving. You can hear them giving cues every once in a while, which I love that. I love when musicians and bands keep that in there, when you can hear them kind of talking to each other, or like I said, shouting a musical cue to one another. Like, I think that's awesome. I love hearing that kind of the membrane and the not tentacles, but the tendons between members. I like when you can hear that, so you can really hear how they come together as a joint, as a connection. You know, things like that just makes the music come alive in a different way. Almost gives you a slightly behind the scenes look. But this, yeah, my mind is gone. Now I am curious, why is this one called number 9? I want to know what happened to 1 through 8. I couldn't even tell you. But I gotta be honest, when I saw the title Sky Church Hymn, I expected something a lot more atmospheric, churchy, like, I don't know. I thought of something more atmospheric. I thought of Oregon. I thought of like something like that. No. This is completely different. But hey, you worship in your own way, right? But off of this absolute chaotic display of fire, how satisfying is it after they melt your mind? Out of that melt, they put you back together, and you are reformed. Reborn, some would say. This is a great piece. Let me know what you guys thought of it, though. You can Let me know in the comments, of course. You can follow me in multiple places. I hope that you're having a wonderful day. If it's morning, did this wake you up? And if it woke you up, was it on the good side or the bad side? Let me know. Hope you're having a wonderful one, though. Thank you so much for being here, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye.